In this video, we're going to discuss the cloud architect role and the cloud engineering role. And we're going to talk about the focus of these roles, why they're so different. We're going to talk about the mindset that you need to be a cloud architect versus a cloud engineer, and why the wrong mindset will get you and hurt you in your job search. And we'll talk about why cloud engineering and hands-on labs will not teach you cloud architecture or solutions architecture, but what you need to do instead. My name is Mike. I'm an enterprise architect with about 25 years of experience, and I've spent more than two decades training engineers and architects. And you can see students of mine at AWS, at Cisco, at Google, at IBM, at Microsoft, Accenture, Deloitte, KPMG, Capgemini, PricewaterhouseCoopers, and many, many other prestigious organizations. So why is the architect in engineering so different? Why is the thinking different? Well, the first thing we need to think about is the job goals of the cloud architect versus the goals of the cloud engineer are completely different. And this is true of any architect like an AI architect or an enterprise architect. The goal of the architect is to design a system to optimize the client's business performance. That means aligning the organization's people, the organization's business processes, and the organization's technology. So the goal of the architect is to help that organization find the most efficient ways for employees to do their jobs, and then find the technology that will supercharge that company's employees so they can do their jobs better than anybody else. Now, what does that cloud engineer do? The cloud engineer's job is about building, tuning, and optimizing the performance of a component or of a few components of the overall big picture. So what does that mean? It means the engineer might be focused on the network and the networking and the routing protocols, the cloud network engineer, for example. But what's the architect focused on? Potentially 1,000 or more elements in the big picture. So that engineer is zoomed in, deeply focused on one element, but the architect is focusing on everything. And why do I say it could be 1,000 things? In an enterprise, there's typically a few hundred applications. There's typically a few thousand routes in the routing table, potentially 100, 200,000 IP addresses being used. They typically have employees located in almost every continent, remote access workers. So things get very complicated. So the architect has to look at that entire big picture, everything that's going on, the business goals, and then all those little components. So let's compare an engineer and an architect. I'm going to use a software engineer to give you some examples of architecture, of engineering, and then I'll give you the things the architect would think about. So let's say I have to have an application written, and we hire some of the best software engineers in the world. And they write simple, elegant, and clean code. And that's one of the things you look for, code that's well organized and easy for others to understand. The software engineer writes code that's easily maintainable so it can be modified or updated easily. The code's efficient to minimize computational resources. The software engineer's code is reliable, scalable, and reusable, and the code is secure. That's what I want out of a good software engineer, of course, someone that can document it as well. But what does the enterprise architect or the cloud architect need to think about? Well, we need to think about something different. So first, we need to think about the application that needs to be developed. And then, of course, we have people develop it. But we need to think about it differently. We need to think about what is the application that the employees actually need? What are the goals of the application? How will the application be used? What is the workflow or business logic that the application needs to support? What are the availability needs of the system? What are the performance needs of the system? Can the application tolerate latency or variations in latency like jitter? Who will be the users of this system? Now, what are the compute needs of the system? How many servers do we need? How many CPU cores? How much DRAM? How much disk IO? How much throughput? How much network performance? And then we think about, okay, now we've got a new application. What does this mean on the network? What does the network need? Do we need to upgrade the network capacity? Does it need security? New QoS on the servers? What kind of operating system we use? How do we harden the operating system? The types of load balancers or reverse proxies we should be using? How many clouds do we need to host the applications? How many CDNs or content delivery networks? What kind of load sharing do we need? How do we secure it? See, the architect's focusing on all these other elements, where the engineer is focused on their part of the system. So that has big implications on an engineer's training, like a cloud engineer's training or a cloud architect's training. The engineer is deeply focused on that tech, and thank Thankfully, somebody is, because we need that person to do it. But the architect is more focused on the business and the way the business operates and the way the employees do their job. And then as architects, we evaluate the technology. Okay, what's best for the company? What's best for the business? What's best in the way employees do things? Which one's going to work with what we have now? Which one's going to be easiest to integrate? So for architects, it's about technology selection after evaluating trade-offs. Engineering is more about the technology itself and tuning it and making that tech sync. So architects are focused on the entire design. So what are the implications of that? That means the architects need to know a little bit about a lot of things. And that means they need to have the good enough leadership skills to create the team that can build everything. What does that mean for the cloud engineer? It means that cloud engineer needs to be good and strong and powerful and have deep, deep, deep knowledge of what these technologies are, how these technologies work, how to build them, how to performance tune them, how to automate them. Whereas that architect's more focused on business and process and executive communication skills and executive leadership skills and the types of questions that need to be asked and the things that need to be supported by the business. This is typically the reason why cloud engineers typically need training to become cloud architects, why software engineers typically need training to become cloud architects, because engineering and architecture are very different, but they're all real important and people on both sides are critically needed. So now you know, if you want to be an architect, focus on learning the strategy of how to design system for business. Don't focus on doing a lot of hands-on engineering labs that are going to teach you how to. Instead, think about how would you solve business challenges? What goes into business architecture? What goes into business needs? What goes into building a business case? What goes into business process tuning? And things that are much more focused on architecture. If you want to become an architect, join me on one of our free architect webinars where we'll go over all the architecture roles. We have different webinars for each. Cloud architect, solution architect, enterprise architect, AI architect, security architect. And we will talk about what we do as architects. We'll talk about the skills you need for each of these roles. We'll talk about how to get interviews and how to get hired with or without experience. Because I actually believe that architecture roles are the best in the world. This has been my life's work for the last 25 years. And I love all the architecture roles I've ever had. Enterprise architect, network architect, security architect, cloud architect. I love them all. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your architecture career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you soon.